Before starting the installation of your smart cabinet, remember to set up your printer on a table first. You can do this by clicking on the video that appears on the screen, or for more information, visit the link in the description. To place your printer on the smart cabinet, unload the filament and disconnect your BCN3D Epsilon, removing the Ethernet cable and power cable. Keep the cables at hand for the last step of the installation. Move the smart cabinet to the side of your printer and lock the wheels using the brakes. With help from another person, lift the printer by firmly holding the handle and the bottom, and place it on top of the smart cabinet. The printer can be secured to your smart cabinet by fitting it into the metal corners. On the right-hand side of the smart cabinet, you have a pull-out maintenance tray where you can store your tools. At the back of the printer, disconnect the Teflon tubes of the FRS. With one hand, press and hold the gray connector down, and at the same time, use your other hand to gently remove the Teflon tube, which should come out easily. Connect the two Teflon tubes to the external outlets that you'll find at the back of the smart cabinet, then connect them to the FRS. Don't forget to attach the coupling clips to the ends of the tubes. If you're using a Wi-Fi dongle, disconnect it and reconnect it to the Wi-Fi dongle port on your smart cabinet. Use the USB link connector to connect the printer with the smart cabinet. If your printer was connected to the network by an Ethernet cable, remember to reconnect it directly to the printer when you put your printer in its designated final position. Connect the power extension cable protruding from the right corner of the smart cabinet to your Epsilon. Now connect the power cable that we previously set aside to the power connector. Finally, connect the power cable to the power supply. Remember to link your printer to BCN3D Cloud to receive updates automatically and enjoy all the features. If your printer is not yet registered, you can easily do so by following the steps from the link in the description. Then load the filament and leave your printer ready for action. To load filament through the smart cabinet, press the opening latch and open the drawer completely. To open the dehumidifying chamber, turn the locking knobs 180 degrees. 90 degrees unlocks the airtight lid, and the next 90 opens the dehumidifying chamber. Lift the airtight cover carefully and rest it on the rear stop. Open the spool and cut the filament tip at a 45-degree angle. Place the filament spool inside the BCN3D spool cartridge and slide the tip in until it protrudes. Place the spool cartridge inside the chamber, orienting the magnet towards the loading point. On the screen, select the extruder and the material to be loaded. Insert the filament through the loading point. As soon as the sensor detects the filament, the extruder motor will be activated. Keep pushing until you notice that the extruder starts to drag it. And the rest of the loading process will be automatic. If the extruder cannot load the filament, cut the tip of the filament at the opposite angle and repeat the process. Repeat the same process to load the other extruder. To load 2.3 kg filament spools, you can install the spool holders in the center column. The smart cabinet accepts spools of different sizes. There are multiple combinations that allow you to place your spools in different ways according to their size. You can check the link in the description to see if your spools are compatible and the different ways of placing them. To finish the loading process, close the airtight lid and turn the locking knobs to seal the compartment. Close the drawer and your Epsilon is ready to print. To ensure best performance, we advise you to only store the filament spools that you'll use soon in the dehumidifying chamber of your smart cabinet. Every time you open the cover of the dehumidification chamber, you'll be renewing the air inside, increasing the humidity levels. For this reason, it's important to open only when it's necessary and to make sure that it's closed properly. If you need more storage space, you can find an additional storage area at the bottom.